basketball, coaching, teaching. That's what I wake up wanting to do. I go to sleep thinking about it. I watch basketball and I stop, I pause, I rewind. Like, that's just the way my brain is wired at the moment.
Specifically in New York, the perception is that Phil asked you to direct the Knicks in a way where you may have had to execute his vision. Was that fair to you as a coach?
I don't know if fair or unfair is the way to phrase it, because we all have people that we have worked for or are responsible to in terms of superiors, the president, the boss, the owner of the business. If you're an employee, you have to do in some ways the things that they would prefer that you do. But in sports, oftentimes, in particular with coaching, managing, leading, it makes it more challenging and more difficult to do your job when there's too much management of what you need to do. And so I just wish that we could have done a better job, not just Phil. The biggest takeaway for me is to just remember that there's goodness that can come out of lack of success, because it motivates me to want to be successful even more as I move forward. And that's why I'm excited to be back in LA now.
You've had a chance to get your hands around this job, I'd imagine. Is there a difference between coaching the NBA as opposed to coaching the WNBA?
There are scientifically proven differences between the way my brain is wired as a man, mm-hmm. and the way Candace Parker's brain is wired as a woman. However, those don't have to be differences in the way of not being able to come together in the same way. If I were coaching men, there would still be ways that I have to figure out how, in relationship with you individually as a man, how are we gonna work together so that I can help you get the best of yourself, right, which then allows you to be the best for the team. I don't think that differs.
The NBA is so athletic. I'm wondering, when you look at the WNBA, not saying that it's not as athletic, but I'm wondering, do you feel like it's a pure brand of basketball when everything's not above the rim? Do you feel like teaching this is closer to the fundamentals of the game?
There are more young women coming up now, mm-hmm. In terms of athleticism and speed and explosiveness. There's an evolution happening, mm-hmm. and we're going to see more of that, I think, as we go forward. But currently, I think that women see the game in a more holistic way at times than what men do. I think as men, we oftentimes take the shortcut and use our physical brute strength, mm-hmm. or athleticism to solve a problem. And I think that in watching and observing women play the game, and probably just naturally, you know, women are more intuitive and thoughtful at times than we are. Mm-hmm. This is a reality. And I think they play the game that way as well.
How do you appreciate success as a player in comparison to galvanizing a group of people and experience success as a coach?
Here's an amazing new opportunity to start to learn some of those things. And I won't have all the answers until we actually do it, right? You don't know. And that's the beauty of sports. That's why you see adults crying after they win the championship, because literally they didn't know until the last second went off the clock. They were not quite sure that it was gonna happen. And so until then, we don't know what all it takes.